Namaste children, hi. Let me discuss special classes for the outbreak of World War II. In the last session, we discussed the main causes or the long-term causes for the outbreak of World War I and World War II. In this session, we are going to discuss the special causes that are responsible for the World War II. What are the special causes are responsible for the outbreak of World War II? They are Treaty of Versailles, Treaty of Versailles, League of Nations, League of Nations, Germany challenged to vengeful domination, fear of socialism and USSR. Fear of socialism and USSR. These are the special causes are responsible for the outbreak of World War II. Let me explain the first special cause for the outbreak of World War II. That is Treaty of Versailles. After the end of World War I, Allied nation conducted a conference on peace at Versailles in the year 1919. This was the biggest conference in the world during that time. Why? Because 32 national delegates attend this conference. That is nearly 3/4 population of the world attended this conference. Who are the countries participated in this conference? USA, UK, France, Italy, Japan were the countries participated in this conference actively, whereas Russia, Socialist Russia, Germany, Austria, Turkey were not invited for this conference. Russia, defeated powers in Second World War, Germany, Austria, Turkey were not invited for this conference. In this conference, Allied nations, without considering the wishes and desires of these countries, of Russia, Germany, Austria, Turkey, they made an agreement called Treaty of Versailles in the year 1919. This agreement consists three conditions. The first one is territorial penalties. Second one is military cuts. Third one is huge compensation. Under territory penalties, firstly, Germany were asked to return the colonies of Africa, which was occupied in the year 1880. And also, they asked Germany to return the European countries like European places like Alsace and Lorraine, which was occupied from France in the year 1870. Under territorial penalties, firstly, Germany were asked to return the colonies of Africa, which was occupied in the year 1880. At the same time, Germany were asked to return the Alsace and Lorraine, which was occupied from the France in 1870 to the European nations. What are the conditions laid down in military cuts? Under military cuts, Germany were asked to reduce the military strength from 9 lakhs to 1 lakhs. And Germany should not maintain submarines. And Germany should maintain 6 battleships, which carry not less than 10,000 tons. And Germany should maintain dozen torpedo boats and destroyers each. Under huge compensation, Germany should pay lot of compensation, lump sums of compensation to Allied nation, as Germany is responsible for First World War. Without calling Germany to this conference, without inviting Germany to this conference, not only Germany, without inviting defeated powers in Second World War, like Germany, Austria, Turkey, without countries, without consulting these countries, without considering the wishes of these countries, without considering the opinion of the countries, without discussing them with these countries, they forced the Germany, Allied nation, forced the Germany to sign an agreement called Treaty of Versailles. So, Germany were forced to sign in the agreement called Treaty of Versailles in the year 1919. By that, Germany lost all the places, so politically she became weak. When Germany forced to sign the agreement in the year 1919, by that, Germany lost her colonies in Africa and also in Europe. By that, Germany politically she became weak. And Germany, okay, by signing this agreement, Germany military strength has become reduced. Germany army become very weak. By signing this agreement, Germany gave lump sums of compensation to the Allied nations as she was responsible for First World War. By that, Germany economically become very weak. Military she become very weak. Politically she become very weak. When Germany become politically, economically, militarily very weak, Germany people got anger on this agreement. Germany people got anger on this agreement. They reacted against this agreement. This reaction paved the way for Second World War. Now, children, let us discuss the special caste of second special caste that are responsible for the outbreak of World War II is League of Nations. Treaty of Versailles Agreement set up League of Nations in the year 1919 to prevent war in future. That means Allied Nation set up a League of Nations under Treaty of Versailles Agreement to prevent war, to promote peace in the world in the year 1919. Its headquarters is in Geneva. Who is the chief architect of League of Nations, or who is the responsible person to form the League of Nations? Woodrow Wilson, the president of USA. Woodrow Wilson, the president of USA, was the responsible person for forming the League of Nations. USA, though USA president Woodrow Wilson was responsible for the formation of League of Nations, USA didn't become a member in League of Nations. USA didn't become a member in League of Nations. Why? USA Parliament called US Congress refused the proposal of Woodrow Wilson. USA Parliament called US Congress refused the proposal of Woodrow Wilson. As a result, USA didn't become the member of League of Nations. And Russia and Germany were not invited to become a member in League of Nations. In 1934, League of Nations has 58 members. League of Nations is an organization prevent many wars by following a method called collective security method. League of Nations settle disputes between the countries through arbitration or negotiation. That means League of Nations act as a middleman and solve the dispute between two countries peacefully. That is called arbitration. Arbitration means acting like a middleman. League of Nations act like a middleman and solve the dispute between two countries peacefully. Negotiation means discussing with that country, solve the problems peacefully. So, League of Nations settled the dispute between two countries through arbitration and negotiation. League of Nations works under several agencies like ILO, WHO, International Court of Justice. League of Nations works under several agencies like ILO, WHO, International Court of Justice. ILO full form, International Labour Organization. This organization promotes the welfare conditions of the labor. This organization promotes the welfare conditions of the labor. WHO, World Health Organization. WHO, World Health Organization. This organization promotes the health conditions of the people all over the world. This organization promotes the health condition of all the people all over the world. International Court of Justice. International Court of Justice settle the disputes between two countries peacefully, amicably, friendly. Though League of Nations conduct several welfare activities regarding health, regarding labor, health, International Court of Justice, League of Nations had a bad name. That League of Nations became responsible for paving Second World War. Though League of Nations conducting several welfare activities regarding labor, health, and International Court of Justice, League of Nations became responsible for the outbreak of Second World War. How? When Hitler of Germany and Mussolini of Italy attacking other countries, League of Nations failed to prevent the Hitler attacks and Mussolini attacks. In League of Nations, okay, when Hitler of Germany, Mussolini of Italy attacked other countries, though League of Nations prevented many war, but it failed to prevent Hitler of Germany attacks, Mussolini of Italy attacks on other countries. This paved the way for Second World War. Now, third special task for the outbreak of Second World War. Let us discuss the third special task for the outbreak of Second World War is Germany challenge to vengeful domination, or Germany challenge to vengeful domination. How this cause is responsible for Second World War? Let me explain. You know that one, Germany was defeated in First World War. Allied nation feels that Germany was responsible for World War One. Who is responsible for World War One? Kaiser William II. He was the king of Germany. Kaiser William II was the king of Germany, was responsible for World War One. When Germany was defeated in First World War, Kaiser William escaped to Holland. After the defeat of Germany in First World War, Allied nations made a treaty with Germany called Treaty of Versailles. Why Allied nations made a treaty with Germany? Why Allied nations made a peace treaty with Germany called Treaty of Versailles? Why? Because to punish Germany, to cripple Germany, to suppress Germany, so that Germany should not develop in future. To punish Germany, to humiliate Germany, to weaken Germany, so that the Germany should not develop in future. For that reason, Allied Nations made a treaty with Germany called Treaty of Versailles. The conditions that are imposed in Treaty of Versailles were put the Germans in slavish. So Germanians got anger on this Treaty of Versailles. They reacted against this agreement. So they said, this agreement was not discussed with us. This agreement made by Allied Nation, before making this Treaty of Versailles agreement, Allied Nation didn't discuss with us. They didn't consult with us. So we don't show responsibility towards this agreement. We don't show respect towards this agreement. So Germanians were angry on this agreement. When Hitler came to power, when Hitler of Germany came to power, he decided to restore the lost territories under Treaty of Versailles. His aim is to dominate the Central Europe and also the whole world. And he want to put the end of restriction on army. So, first he developed industries in large scale and produced more products sold to foreign countries and earned a lot of money. By that, Germany economy became stable. Germany economy was improved. Next, he increased his military strength now from 1 lakh to more than 10 lakh. He set up, he produced more submarines. He also set up more number of battleships and made his army very strong now. He set up an armament industry and produced large number of arms and weapons and made his army very stronger. After making his army stronger, he decided to recover the lost territories under Treaty of Versailles. So Hitler declared war on Poland on 1st September 1939.
to recover the lost territories. This led to World War II. This led to World War II. Now, children, let me explain about the fear of socialism and USA. It's the last special class for the outbreak of Second World War. But revolution took place in Russia in the year 1917. That is called Russian Revolution. In the revolution, Lenin became the ruler of Russia. Why? Before Russian Revolution, year 1917, in the year 1917 October, who ruled Russia? Provincial government ruled Russia. Under provincial government rule, people suffered without food to eat, without land to cultivate the crop, without job, and without peace. Taking advantage of this condition, Lenin promised the people, Lenin promised the Russians, a Soviet, that if I come to power, I'll do land for landless people and landless peasants. I'll do job for jobless people. I'll give peace for the soldiers. And I'll nationalize banks and industries. By giving up these promises, by saying up these promises, by giving these promises, Russians and Soviet gave full support to Lenin. With the help of Russian support, with the help of Soviet support, Lenin seized the power from provincial government in the month of October 1917. According to Russian calendar, according to our international calendar, he seized the power from provincial government in the year November 1917. And thus he became the ruler of Russia. As he belonged to communist government, he set up a communist government in Russia. Thus Russia became a communist state. After becoming the ruler of Russia, the first act done by communist government was Russia made a peace agreement with Germany and withdraw from World War I. So Russia didn't participate till the end of the World War I. Russia withdrew from the middle of the World War in the year 1917. When Lenin became the ruler of Russia, the Lenin communist government first act is, Lenin made a peace agreement with Germany and withdrew from the World War I in the year 1917. And later, he fulfilled all the promises. And Russia became a big country called USSR in the year 1924. What? Expand USSR, Union of Soviet Socialist Republic, formed in the year 1924. After the end of World War I, in the year 1918, millions of people lost their job in industries, factories, banks and business organizations. Food sold at higher prices. The people don't have money to buy the food at higher prices as they don't have job. So they lived with starvation. As a result, the workers turned into ideology of socialism and communism and starting peace movement. Now, Britain got the fear. If socialism spread in Europe, the people start to peace movement. If people start to peace movement, then British get some problems. The British put into danger. So immediately, to avoid spreading socialism in Europe, to avoid spreading peace movements in Europe, British encouraged Hitler. As he was against socialism, British encouraged Hitler against Russia and against Soviet socialism called appeasement policy of Hitler. So children, this important concept you may not understand. Once again, I am repeating you what you mean by appeasement policy of Hitler. Britain encouraged Hitler against Soviet socialism in order to avoid socialism and peace movements in Europe. It's called appeasement policy of Hitler. Now Germany and USA made a non-aggression pact in the year 1939. Under this agreement, Germany and USA should not fight each other, should not attack each other. Now Germany mastery of the world. The Hitler of Germany's aim is to bring the entire world under his control. And he wants to be the master for the entire world. So to dominate the whole world, Germany attacked Britain first and France, second France. Thus Second World War began. In the beginning of Second World War, Britain and France were defeated in Germany, under Germany. In the beginning of Second World War, Britain and France were defeated under Germany. And next, Hitler of Germany decided to attack USSR in the year 1942. Though Germany made a non-aggression pact with USSR 1939, his aim is to dominate the whole world, so he attacked USSR in 1942. Now, Italy joined Germany group why? Now, Italy joined with Germany group why? Because to protect from France, Italy joined with Germany group and they become friends. Why Japan joined Germany group? Why? There's a big flashback is that Japan occupied East Asia countries. USA requested not to occupy East Asian countries. Japan refused to accept the USA request. USA stopped supplying scrap oil to Japan. That means those days, USA used to supply scrap oil to Japan. When USA stopped supplying scrap oil to Japan, Japan got angry. Japan dropped a bomb at Pearl Harbor in USA. Japan dropped a bomb at Pearl Harbor in USA. So USA got angry. To take revenge on Japan, USA joined in Britain group. To take revenge on Japan, USA joined in this group. At last, Britain, France, USSR, USA formed a group called Allied Powers. Germany, Italy, Japan. When USA joined in Britain group, Japan jumped into Germany group. Now Germany, Italy, Japan formed into Axis group. Now the war occurred between Axis group and Allied groups in the year 1939. This led to World War. Children, so far we discussed about the special classes that are responsible for World War. Well, they are Treaty of Versailles, League of Nations, German challenge to vengeful domination, fear of socialism and USSR. Children, and in the next session, we are going to discuss about consequences of the World War. To complete this lesson, we have taken 6 videos, children. Keep on watching these videos. If you don't understand the lesson, see these videos repeatedly by keeping the textbook in front of you. Otherwise, we'll teach you this lesson in detail in the classroom sessions. There, we rectify our thoughts very clearly, children. Thank you, children.